Next up.
Speaking of the Pacers in Indiana.
Dontell Mays is in Indiana,
we
man.
We have Indiana's own. Holy shit. Hold on a second. He covered up his Indiana tattoo. That's a cover-up on his fucking stomach. That son of a bitch. Hold on a that second.
He
literally had Indiana state flag right there. I think he covered it up. Oh, my God.
I mean, who the hell's proud of Indiana?
Hold on. I think, unless it's his other side. Oh, no, okay. I think it's his other side. Oh, thank God.
Oh, thank Jesus God. Jesus Christ. Yes. Oof. That would have been bad. Jeffersonville, stand up. Fucking Indiana.
It's a great town.
I just couldn't imagine being from such a nothing state and being so proud of it.
Well, I'm a great person. I think I represent the state greatly, proudly.
I agree. I think the fact that you still have all of your teeth is a huge win for the state.
These are real too, motherfucker. Those,
and they are nice teeth. Next up, at UFC Vegas 74, we have Andre Arlovsky. At 45, how the hell old is he now? 44?
I think he's taking 46, on, honestly.
Taking on Dontell Mays. Andre Arlovsky, favorite, minus 140, flip to a dog. Again, I said four. I think it's five or six fights in this card have done that full-blown flip. And what's so funny is last week, when you had Temba Garimbo as your underdog lock of the week, people are like, oh, these next 2 weeks are tough. Temba's a tough, I don't know about him. And next week, all we have is, what do we have, Dontell Mays? We can't count on him. And he was still an underdog. And now there's people that see him at minus 110, minus 120. They're like, I'll put more money on this guy. So it's just so funny.
Indiana's own, baby. Indiana's never lost at anything. Think about the people. Larry Bird's never lost. Michael Jackson only took one L. That was a pretty big L, but, you know, he did take that L.
You won all those trials.
Darren Elkins. Never lost. Jim Gaffigan. Dave Letterman.
Okay, we're done here. What a stupid
I mean, thing. I could keep going.
Dontell Mays, full-blown favorite in this fight. And I get it. He's dangerous, good boxer, has all the things. But he's taking on veteran Andre Arlovsky, 34-21. He is 4-1 in his last five. He's not on this wild downslope. Yes, he is coming off of a loss. Technically a submission loss to Marcos Rogério de Lima, but he was popped, he was dropped, and then he was submitted. Dontell Mays is 9-5. Obviously, a very different numbers in his career versus Andre Arlovsky. He's only 2-2. Actually, 2-2-1 in his last five. And he's coming off that decision loss to Augusto Sakai, who the UFC just cut, even though he was coming off a win. But Andre, at this point, straight up legend. Some of you newer fight fans that are here, you know, the Conor era, you don't realize that Andre Arlovsky is the former heavyweight champion of the world. And one of the of his eras before heavyweights were like insanely well-rounded, Andre Arlovsky was the best heavyweight of that generation fighter. Absolutely incredible. And he's still very, very talented. Seems to have lost a lot of the power in his hands, but he's a very technical striker. He'll come forward, pretty busy guy, knows how to use his physicality well. He'll hold you against the cage. Not the most exciting guy like he used to be, but he is a calculated striker who knows what he's doing. He has become a bit of a decision machine these last few years. His chin had been holding up for quite a while, but he showed a couple cracks in that last fight. And just like the Jin Yu Fry breakdown, I just don't know what's left of it. He's taking on Dontell Mays. Dontell Mays, decent boxer, very, very heavy hands. He does have solid footwork, sets up combinations well. He comes forward, throws everything with power, even his leg kicks. We've seen him wrestle as well. He's got 7 takedowns in his UFC career so far. Man, this is a tough fight to break down, but I do agree with the fact that Andre opened as a favorite. I think he should be the favorite here. He's old. He's fighting Dontell Mays, who has insane power, but in every single category other than Andre's old, Andre Arlovsky's the better fighter. Every single category. Every single one. He's going to be the better striker, the more experienced guy. He's actually probably going to be faster here as well. He's going to have just everything. He literally is going to be better everywhere. So the only reason anybody would say Dontell Mays is going to win this fight is because you don't trust Andre's chin. And I'm not going to argue with that. I don't know if I trust the chin either, but I do think Andre Arlovsky is going to win this fight. He's an absolute legend. I hope he wins. I hope he retires, and I think he's going to get it done. And if this line keeps moving,
because what are you going to do?
I'll throw money on Andre Arlovsky if he keeps going. Love the guy. What do you think?
Yeah, bet with your heart. That's
44.
What can go wrong with that? The thing's about to go anyway. did you know that Artem, do you know what Artem was calling Dontale?
What?
Someone in Discord said he was calling him Dontale or something like that. Imagine that. How do you even say that in a fucking Australia or New Zealand? Dontale. I don't know. Oh, Artem, you sleeping bitch. listen, this is one of those fights where if you want to bet, I mean, obviously I made fun of betting for your heart, but this is one of those fights where don't try to make money off this fight, right? Bet for, have fun. If you want to have some fun while you watch it, bet for your heart, whatever it is, because who the fuck knows what's going to happen in this fight. You saw Dontale Mays in his last fight almost looked like he was like uninterested. I mean, there was nothing about that fight where he was like, oh, this guy's in it. He wants to fight. He's trying to get out of positions. It was like he didn't even want to be there. Andre Arlovsky was almost kind of the same thing. He was taken down. The guy was threatening the choke. The second the arm went under, he didn't try to fight it or anything. He just immediately tapped. Well, he
was dropped bad, though.
I know, but he was fighting down there for a little bit, and then the second that it was under, he didn't try. I mean, he didn't try to do anything. And it looked to me like it was like, what am I still doing here? Like, what? I mean, it was like, like, get me the fuck out of this. So I think both these guys, it's like, I mean, if you're Dontale Mays and you come in, you can't beat, I know it's Andre Arlovsky, but this is not the same guy. You can't come in here and beat this 44, 45-year-old with just keeping range, using your athleticism. I think he's going to have the speed advantage, just boom, 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 boom. You don't have to load up. Eventually, you're going to beat him down and find that chin. I don't know what you're doing. If you're not coming in here and just kind of, honestly, should probably smoke Andre Arlovsky. I don't know what you're doing, but I can see Andre just kind of making it dirty, getting in his face, getting those same clinch positions Sakai was in, and then all of a sudden Andre just won this decision. So, you know, this is stay away from this if you're trying to make money, but my pick, I got to stick with my dude, man. Indiana Zone, Dontale Mays, baby. Naptown represent, 317. You heard?
Would he still be your pick if that tattoo was covered up?
No, hell no. Fuck that guy.
Well, there we go. I do think Andre's going to get it done, though. Dontale's just big looping shot. It's just, it's a bit sloppy. And what's crazy is this is another fight. We have heavyweights, a 44-year-old heavyweight. We have heavyweight strikers and a 2.5-round line. And the over is minus money. This is expected to go to a decision. And you can't even bet it because it's a freaking heavyweight fight. It's crazy to bet an over 2.5 in a heavyweight fight. Crazy.
You said it's a freaking heavyweight. I thought you were about to say it was. It's a freak fight. It's a freak show fight. Or something. I was like, Jesus.
Well, and I mentioned this in the quick picks, but it's not as pertinent now because Jim Miller has a new opponent. But the UFC is not typically kind to its aging veterans, right? They're like, hey, let's make a name off some young stud.
Here's Conor McGregor, cowboy.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, fuck you.
So Andre Arlovsky is actually the perfect guy to make a name. Like they should have given him Waldo Cortez and let Waldo dance around and be fun and light up Andre Arlovsky.
I can't stand that guy.
But you get what I'm saying? Like typically what they would do, but they actually gave Andre Arlovsky like, hey, you could win this fight.
We're not done with you yet, buddy. Yeah. We're going to try and make you the champ again. Yeah. Here's Dontale Mays. Please fucking win this fight. We're going to give you fucking God next.
Well, but then Jim Miller, who's similar age, they're like, here's Ludovic Klein. It's like, oh, fuck. But anyway, he's got a new opponent. But
former lock Jacob of the week, and I, greatest lock of the week of all time, Ludovic Klein.
Jacob and I split on this fight, but we're both... Not we're split.
$100
Like right, yeah, we're right. I'll do $100 on.
Yeah,
this
fight. I'll throw $100 on this one.
All right, well, +120.
You really want to just do $100? Okay.
No, I'll do $100. I'll do $100. All right, good. Well, then I don't need to watch the line and pay a bookie. We did it. I will spend the $7,700 in DraftKings. But I'm gonna have to look a little closer because Andre Arlovsky doesn't really score that well because it's just jab, jab, lean on the cage. Jab, jab, lean on the cage. I don't think there's a finish, but if he does, he's a crafty veteran. And if he just holds Dontale against the cage the whole time, it's going to be a boring-ass fight. But that is control time.
I think he has the fight IQ. I think Sakai didn't realize how much Dontale really didn't kind of want to be there. I think if Andre sees him tired, sees him lackadaisical, he'll chase a finish. I mean, he knows what he's doing in there.
Yeah, tried and true vet at this point. All right. Cool. DraftKings, you just spend the $8,500 on Dontale.
See you guys later.
You're going to spend
the I almost got excited. I was like, oh, whoa. You know what's funny is like the whole Discord is calling this like the card, like the Andre Orlovsky versus Dontell Mays, like UFC Las Vegas 74, Orlovsky versus Mays and stuff. So it's funny that we ended it like that. But seriously, well, thanks for watching, guys.
There's 300 people in here. We appreciate it, especially after an off week. We own picks.com, $10 a month. Become a member. You unlock it's I don't even have to say all the things. It's the best value in this space. Period. End
Get
of story.
Me to Brazil. $10 a month. Get me to Brazil. Let me stop doing this shit, guys. Become a premium member today.
If people like you, they're not gonna want you to stop. So just say, let me do this from Brazil.
They're canceling
in droves.
Oh my God. Imagine me streaming in Brazil. Imagine how much fun this would be if I was actually a happy person, happy with my life, enjoying my life, how much more entertaining I could even be. I mean, this is just such a facade, such a fake. I put the mask on every time I get in front of the camera. Imagine if I was actually happy in Brazil with my fucking hot ass Brazilian wife. Holy shit. Por de repetir, por favor.
I wish this was the end of a stream because that would have been a great place to just hit end.
Jesus, please become a premium member.
If you want to support the cause, weownpicks.com. It's only $10 a month. Just click become a member at the top.